At this age in my life, I've rediscovered all the sensual and emotional aspects of classical music.
Billy Joel on his greatest hits and his new direction.
I'm not 18 anymore. I'm not going to make believe I am. I have to have more substance in life. I have to have more challenges. And this is what I find challenging.
It's a challenge to work with athletes.
I think of myself as a piano player, as a musician, as a composer, then a lyricist. Way down the road, I'm a singer, and I'm a performer, and a recording artist, and a rock star, whatever it is I'm supposed to be.
Did you realize that you were going to have three greatest hits volumes when you started your career?
I really had no idea I was going to have a career which would enable me to put out three greatest hits albums. I was notified by the record company that since the last sets of greatest hits had come out, that there had been so many singles that qualified to make the greatest hits album. It's strange to hear songs out of context, taken out of the context of the album, but I've heard them on the radio already, on their own. So hearing them end to end as radio songs, it's not the context I wrote them in, but those are the ones that most people know.
I've made fortune, I spent fast enough, but as for women, they don't know.
Song, Baby Graham, mentioned he wanted. He shows up in the studio, and the guy looks just like Ray Charles. It's sort of like the Washington Monument just moved into the studio, and there he is with the shades. This is really going to happen. I was nervous. I was like a little kid all over again.
When the evening shadow and the stars appear.
I did songs by other writers on this album because I haven't been writing songs for the last 3 years. The last song I wrote was On the River of Dreams. It was the last song on the River of Dreams album, and it was called Famous Last Words. And the lyrics actually say, these are the last words I have to say. And now it's time to put this book away. And that's the story of my life. I don't know if I put a hex on myself by doing that or if it's self-fulfilling prophecy. But for the last couple of years, I've been writing piano pieces and orchestral pieces and, I guess, classical music.
Article in the Daily News today says I got writer's block. I haven't been able to write. Does this look like I haven't been able to write?
In the beginning.
At least half of the popular music that I've written originated as pure music played on the piano. Even a song like Uptown Girl started out as a classical piece of music. The pieces I'm writing now are really not all that different in the approach than the pieces I've always written before.
Now, have you started recording your classical music?
Well, I'm not the person to be performing it. We're working with a pianist from Russia who is interpreting my music for piano and will be performing on public radio.
Tanglewood.
Up in Tanglewood.
How do you feel about that it's going to be performed soon?
I'm a little nervous about what kind of reception it's going to get. I'm sure there are classical critics sitting out there with a knife and a fork just dying to carve up some rock and roll guy who thinks he's going to waltz in and start composing classical music. And I'm really writing it for me. I'm not writing it for critics. I'm not even writing it for an audience. I never have. I was always writing for me.
Oh, I could walk in your shoes.
one last question. You said that to do this, to be a composer, creator, you have to be a maniac. Are you a maniac?
Well, I think that I have some quirks and eccentricities as a human being. I think I've written songs about manic depression. I don't necessarily
feel
like
I'm... No, I didn't mean... I meant that humorously. I didn't mean that in any...
That's okay. I think most musicians are, in some respect, manic depressive, but they utilize it. It's useful to go from high to low. You can write like Beethoven. He was one of the great manic depressives of all time. He wrote exhilarated music, and he wrote extremely sad music, and it worked. Because whenever you get tired of the happy stuff, you want to cut it with a little bit of, you know, Sturm und Drang and angst. So there's nothing wrong with being able to utilize your eccentricities, your quirks, your frailties, your humanity, really.
Which would work for your classical music.
Well, it's working for me.